Welcome back here to Adelante Chicago. Dr. Ricardo Rosenkranz is a well-known neonatologist who's treated patients at Northwestern Hospital for years, but he's now taking center stage for a hobby that has really become his passion, and that's magic and illusions. Dr. Rosenkranz is here to tell us all about his new show, Physician Magician. Thank you for coming in. This
is
fun.
I'm so delighted to be here. Thank you so much.
You know, I was telling you earlier that there seems to be more of an interest in magic within the Latino community, not
Absolutely.
Just people performing it, but people going to watch it from our neighborhoods.
Absolutely. There have been many TV shows that have showcased magic from all over the world, and there are wonderful performers from all walks of life, and certainly the Latino community is one. And magic has always been a fun thing my childhood in Mexico.
Yeah.
I wasn't interested in magic when I was a child.
That's so interesting. Yeah, because you have a very unique story. You're a doctor, a physician, and you decided to sort of get into the business of magic and illusions. How does that happen?
Well, yes, I had no interest in it. I was in Mexico with my family, and on a Saturday in Mexico City, all of a sudden we walked into what I like to call the magic store that time forgot. Real bricks and mortar store, like there are very few in the world left. Mm-hmm. And the magician there used to come to my house when I was a child. He would perform the magic for you, and if you wanted to buy it, then he would take you to the back and teach you how it was done.
Wow.
Yes.
Okay.
And then I was sort of hooked at that point, and I started doing it. That was about I was already 35 at the time, and that became a pathway to other bigger, greater things. And in fact, I brought for you.
And here you are today, and you actually brought us a little bit of one of the magic tricks that you do.
Well, I brought this thing, which was the first thing I bought from Champs.
And you've kept it all these years.
I kept it all these years. I really don't do any card magic, particularly in my show. I have one card thing. But I like this because I find that this is a very sweet and nice thing to do, and so I'm going to do it for you right now.
Okay.
I'm going to go like this and sort of move the cards, and when you say stop, we'll stop.
Okay.
Okay? You ready?
Here we go.
You say stop.
Stop. Okay.
Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And so now we put the lock.
Okay.
And you remember the card?
Yes, I think. No, I do.
So now the card can't escape.
No.
Right? There's no sleight of hand here. What was the card that you selected?
Nine of spades. Try to find it. Let's see, nine of spades. I'm looking. Now, is this one of the shows, one of the tricks in your show or no?
No, it isn't.
I don't see it here.
No.
Get out of here.
Because it's here.
Ah! Oh, you got me. I don't see how you did that. I was watching you all along the
way.
It
was so charming. And at that point, I really didn't know where this could go, but I found an amazing mentor here in Chicago, a great magician by the name of Eugene Berger, and I learned that magic really could have meaning, and that you could use meaning to teach other things. So while this is just a fun card magic effect, I discovered that I could use magic to teach medical students certain concepts, and that I could create magic performances that talked about something more than just the illusion itself.
Yeah.
That's what intrigued me about magic.
Yeah, so you can explain sort of complicated topics by using magic and getting people engaged in that way.
Exactly. I started teaching at the medical school using magic at the end, and I started getting teaching awards, of course, because students enjoyed that. And my show is a lot about that. The magic is the magic performances are lovely, and that is really the aim, is to create wonder, but they're all about something. This particular show is about using metaphors in our life to try to achieve the impossible for ourselves.
And we're watching some pictures of whether,
yes.
I don't know if this is the magic show that people can see coming up.
Yes. That is my sidekick friend, Balsamo.
Great name.
Because every doctor has a skull. And this is our beautiful theater, the Rhapsody Theater, that opened last year. It's in Rogers Park, and it's a wonderful place to do a show.
Okay, and so this magician physician, did I get the order?
Physician magician. Yes.
So it's going on right now, and it'll run until when?
It's an open run.
Mm-hmm.
One of those nice advantages. So it's been in English, and it will continue. It's Thursdays, Fridays, Saturdays, and Sundays. But starting the 2nd of April, the Sunday shows are in Spanish.
That's so
almost
great.
Every week. Here and there, I have to take my kids to do things, but the shows are in Spanish. And I have one particular weekend Where I'm super excited because I'm doing the 2 o'clock show in Spanish and then I'm doing a 6:30 p.m. show in English.
Is it difficult to sort of translate some of the magic that you've been doing in English for years into Spanish? I imagine probably for somebody like you, it's not.
So Spanish is my first language, but I try to be okay. elegant. So I've looked at all of the scripts and really had to write them and make sure that they worked beautifully.
I love it. All right, so we have the information right there up on our screen, Rhapsody Theater in Rogers Park. Go to rhapsodytheater.com to buy.